In today's video, we're going to do a reader Q&A. Over the next couple of weeks, we're going to do a bunch more of these too. I have a lot of questions from you that you want answered, so we should get to it, right? I mean, you got questions, I got answers. Let's just start right away. Paul asks, what's your take on couchsurfing? Paul, I love couchsurfing. I think it's a great service that connects travelers with locals and not only gives you free accommodation, but gives you a local person to show you around, tell you the cool places to go, what to see, where to eat. One of my favorite sharing economy websites and one I highly recommend budget travelers to use. And it's good for solo travelers, couples, and families. Everybody's on that site, so definitely use it. Alicia asks, what kind of gear do I use to keep my documents safe when I travel? Well, I'm sure I'm gonna let a bunch of you down with this answer, but I don't use anything. I don't have a money belt. I don't have some sort of secret safe or, you know, hidden compartments. I have a copy of my passport and I have extra bank cards. You know, I have all my important numbers written down in case things do get lost or stolen. But, you know, when I'm sightseeing for the day, I'm not carrying all my stuff with me. I'm carrying just enough money for the day. All my important documents are locked up in a locker. I keep my own lock. That's the most I do. Just act like you would back home and you won't make yourself a target. And in a similar question, Yassine asks, what would I do if I lost my wallet with all my money in it? Well, you know what, Yassine? I actually wouldn't care. I never leave my hostel or hotel or couch surfing or Airbnb place with all my stuff. I take enough money for the day and the rest stays locked up where I'm staying. So if I lose a credit card or I lose, you know, 50 bucks, it's not the end of the world because I have backups. So next question, right? Next question is a good one. Clara asks, should you quit school to travel or just take trips in between school years? This is a good question because I just read a whole article about it. You can see the link right down below. There's really no right answer. Some people should quit school. Some people should take trips in between. It really depends on what your goal is. My general opinion is that if you know why you're going to school and you know what you're going to get out of it, go to school. Do it. Education is important, but don't go to school just because you're supposed to go to school. Don't waste money. Don't waste your time. If you have no idea why you were there, you should probably wait to go until you know why you're going to be there. But it varies for every person, so I don't really want to make a blanket statement, and I can go on and on and on and on about this subject. Next question is from Suzanne. She asked a very, very common question. What's my favorite food and what's my favorite place? Favorite food? Japanese food. Hands down, love it. Could eat sushi for breakfast. Give me ramen noodles all day, every day. Favorite place? Hands down, Thailand. Love that country. I miss it. Whenever I have Thai food, it brings me home. I used to live in Thailand. A large part of me is still there. So Crystal wants to know, will traveling for long periods of time without work hurt you in trying to get your future job? The answer is no. You can use your travel as a way to showcase good skills employers want. Soft skills, the ability to be independent, to survive on your own, to communicate effectively with people from various cultures, to be able to figure things out, you know, in unknown situations. These skills cannot be taught in business school or whatever school you go to. Travel, it can be a huge asset, okay? Just because you have a year gap between, you know, jobs doesn't mean you're unemployable. It means you've learned other skills. Play up those skills from your travels and you suddenly become a more desirable employee. Chrissy wants to know how I deal with water in places that might not be safe to drink. I drink tap water wherever I can. If there's a country I can't drink tap water, I just get bottled water. And I get one of those bottled waters where the cap has a filter. So I just pour it in, put the cap on, and it's filtered. You can also use a SteriPen, which will use UV radiation to kill all the bacteria in the water. And that's really good if you're going into the African bush or the Australian outback or really in the backcountry and camping for a long time. Francesco wants to know what scares me the most about a trip. That's a good question, Francesco. Don't really know. I've never really thought about it. I guess I still get nervous over the what ifs. You know, even, you know, 8 years doing this, right before I'm about to leave, I'm always saying, what if something goes wrong? What if I don't meet anybody? What if I can't find my way? What if I get robbed? What if, what if, what if? right before I step on that plane, I still have those, you know, stupid fears. I know they're dumb and they don't make any sense, but, you know, I cycle through all the fears, I get on the plane, I land, and I realize everything's gonna work out just fine. And everything does work out just fine. Yeah, there's ups and downs along the way, but that's travel. Nothing is ever perfect, but, you know, if you keep a good head on your shoulders, use some common sense, and trust that people are innately good, talk to people, and just go in with an open mind, you're gonna have a great trip. Tony asked a question I get a lot. How do you handle travel burnout? What do you do when you don't want to see another temple or waterfall or walk in a jungle or see a museum, and all you want to do is watch Netflix and eat Chinese food? Well, I found the best solution for travel burnout is to watch Netflix and eat Chinese food. Don't keep moving on. Don't keep going. Stay in one place. Rest. Relax. Stop traveling. And then when you're ready, move on. Everybody needs a break, right? We all need a break from our job. We all want a vacation. Well, sometimes travel is kind of like work. You have to, you know, figure out how to go, where to meet people, deal with currencies, deal with train systems. It can be a mentally exhausting thing. You know, it's a lot of work, and people don't really realize that when they're starting. So months in, you can really get burnt out, and when you do, just stop and relax and just wait it out. Well, guys, that's this week's questions. We'll have more questions next week. Leave your questions in the comments section below. And until next time, travel cheaper, better, and longer. I hope to see you somewhere out in the world.